darling. Dinner.
But you did that already.
That was last night, Chloe.
That was last night.
That was a dinner party.
That was a dinner party.
A dinner party, darling, where everybody...
With dancing.
Everybody was dancing.
It was much different.
It isn't different. What?
We're going to eat lots of beautiful things.
And bring you back some.
Some of these.
Frog legs.
And tilapia di Apollo.
Livery lamentons.
With onions.
And a delicious goose pate.
And black and red wings. Black and red wings.
And a Normandy rough smoothie.
All sorts of things.
All sorts of things.
Who's going to stay with me?
Well, now, that's an extra.
Extra?
Extra surprise.
Oh, neighbor!
Mrs. Fish?
I'm over to the left.
The ogre?
Mr. Quaday.
Mr. Quaday, the ogre?
Not ogre, Chloe, neighbor.
The ogre's going to stay with me.
Mr. Quaday's not an ogre.
Mr. Quaday's not an ogre.
He has a tail.
For goodness sake!
Now look!
Look what your father's brought
you! What I brought you!
Where did you get that?
Where, from Mr. Quaddy?
From the ogre's garden!
Oh. From Mr. Quaddy's garden!
Oh, maybe back from Oxenham!
Did you ask him for that, Rose?
No, no.
You didn't ask him!
No, I asked.
You stole the ogre's rose!
Mr. Quaddy's not an ogre!
Mr. Quaddy's not an ogre!
He's our neighbour! And I'm sure he doesn't mind.
You stole the ogre's rose, and now he's coming over. What are you saying?
One second, darling.
Yes, Mr. Quaday now! Mr. Quaday, you've met my wife, Laura.
Charming.
My daughter, Chloe.
Charles.
You bought a little book, I can see.
He has a tail.
Yes, one of yours. Well, one of many.
My husband, on his way back from Oxenham.
Yes, on my way back from Oxenham. You don't mind? You see our daughter, Chloe?
My daughter, Chloe.
Had an idea.
Thought you might mind.
Out of all roses.
Just this one little.
This single rose. You don't mind? Ah, look at the time.
Oh, God, the time.
Oh, no, I had no idea it was so late.
Time just flies.
It just flies.
Don't you find that so, Mr. Quaddy, the time just flies by?
There's food in the fridge, and there's matches made up for emergency. And if you need to just...
Honey, the traffic.
Oh, the traffic!
The traffic will be terrible!
Just a terrible, a real mess!
A terrible mess!
And the parking!
Oh, the parking!
Just a terrible...
A nightmare, just such a... You would not believe. Well, then, we're going.
Yes!
Well, bye-bye now.
Goodbye!
Bye-bye.
Chloe, will you marry me?
I know what you are, Mr. Quaday.
Chloe, will you marry me?
No, Mr. Quaday. I can see.
I'm for time.
I know.
You wanna read it? Once upon a time!
Once upon a time!
Once upon a time!
Once upon a time!
There were
three!
friends of a king.
But the king was dead.
But the king.
Like the queen.
The king was dead.
They were on their own.
And the nursemaid ran the house.
The three king's sons.
One had fair hair.
One had silver hair.
One had hardly any hair.
The three king's sons
lived their
they
lives.
They
were happily living their lives.
Getting up in the morning.
Greeting the day.
Shaking hands.
And curling their hair.
Going about all their princely tasks.
Drinking their horses in their shiny tears.
Buying up paintings and eating food.
Looking at things.
And looking away.
Searching for their keys and tying up their shoes and their ties.
And making interesting comments.
And checking the mail for interesting news. And feeling big things about a lot of different things.
And seeing a bit of dust on the floor.
And picking it up.
Then,
all of a sudden.
One day,
they knew.
It was time to get married!
Ambassador,
go all over the world and find three girls to match these portraits and bring them back for us to marry.
The ambassador embarked upon his task, found three fisherman daughters who resembled the portraits, dressed them up as princesses, and showed them to the king's sons, who said,
"Yes, we will marry them! We all like one another! We will get married!"
Now, what joy and celebration, what celebration and joy! What a joyous celebration came over everyone! Everybody was celebrating, everyone felt joy! Everybody was eating cakes and staying up late, dressing up, and posing for portraits, and dancing for joy! Everyone included, everyone except for one.
The nursemaid was not celebrating at all. Life went on as before.
The three king's sons
lived their lives.
They were happily living their lives.
Getting up in the morning.
Greeting the day.
Shaking hands.
And combing their hair.
Going about all their princely tasks.
Visiting their horses in their charioteers.
Buying up paintings and eating food.
Looking at things.
And looking away.
Searching for the keys and tying up their shoes and their ties.
And making interesting comments.
And checking the mail for interesting news. And feeling big things about a lot of different things.
And seeing a bit of dust on the floor.
And picking it up. And then one day. And then one.
And then one day! War broke out!
It was supposed to last 7 days.
Don't kill us!
It lasted 17 years.
Oh no! Don't kill us!
The young princes went off to the war, leaving those three blind queens alone with the dreaded nursemaid.
Mother?
Ambassador, I hate those three queens.
Father?
I hate them with a passion.
Who's there?
Take those three queens to the mountain.
Let us go back to fishing in the stream.
And kill them there. And bring me back their eyes as proof that they are dead.
Don't kill us!
Who will say they had an accident? And I will run the house again.
Oh no! Don't kill us! See? We have torn our own eyes out. Leave us on the mountainside. We can live.
Hey!
excess. Where do we do something to eat?
There are people starving in the world.
Won't you have a little dance with us?
There are people who are lame.
Won't you give us a little smile?
The world is terrible.
Oh, princess, the world is perfectly delightful.
It's perfectly delightful.
Won't you give us a little smile?
It's just delightful.
So I told them. I would smile for all the gold in the mountains. I would laugh for all the treasure in the sea. Nor have you fastened every star in the sky into the hems of all my gowns. Nor if the poets and philosophers of the world were to write to me, nor if the muses themselves were to sing to me. You can take the charm of the ocean and the plains and the meadows in the springtime, and the scent of the grass and the sound of the larks and the sparrows, and shove it all in a box. This kingdom will blacken and crumble, and everything in it will wither and die, and everyone here, and their children, and their children's children, and their children's children's dogs and cats and goldfish and fuzzy little rabbits will be cold and buried and decomposing with maggots crawling out of their eyes before I can set to laugh, because I know what the world is really like.
Oh, you don't mean that,
everybody says. So then my stupid father goes.
I know. Let's have a contest. Whoever can make my daughter smile or even laugh, she may win.
Whatever. Like I'm so totally, totally sure. So I go, agreed. But if a suitor tries to make me laugh and doesn't succeed, we cut off his head.
Agreed. Sounds fair to me.
So now they're coming, like I can hardly wait.
Suitor number one. So, Zachary!
Alright, you guys need to get that fixed. No, seriously. My princess, what do you call a princess on a dating profile? Tinderella. Right. What do you call a Disney princess who loves a bit of chocolate? Kinderella. Alright, moving away from the princess jokes. What did the giant say when he came out of the closet? Surprise! You know what? It takes real guts to be an organ donor.
Choose a card.
Show the audience.
All right. Look at my eyes, look at my eyes. What is the colour of your hair?
Brown.
And how many wives did King Henry VIII have?
Six.
And how many fish are in the sea?
Too many.
All right. Is this your card?
No.
Well then, surely this is your card?
No.
Well, you know,
third time's a charm.
Is this your card?
No.
Great, that will be.
I know it's somewhere in here. Is this your card? No, is it this one? This one, it must be this one. No, my love, look, look, look. Is it this one? Is it your card?
Whoever I marry must take a note.
King and a queen. The queen had short yellow hair, and so did her daughter, whose name was Aleraia. One day, the queen sickened and died. Who would be the king's new bride?
Thank you.
remarry, there is something you should know.
She must be as pretty as me, and that's impossible.
But still, you must find her and marry her! Now go! Now go!
Unless you give me a gown as bright as the moon. Not unless you give me a gown as radiant as the sun.
Quardet.
Once upon a time, there was a man with several sons and a daughter.
Most of all.
I'm going to my book now. Once upon a time, there was a man with seven sons and a daughter. The sons were young and loud, and one day, were young and loud than usual. The father was impatient to read his course. I wish all my sons were swans. And immediately, they are.
Went into the courtyard and found the feathers her brothers had left behind. She ran off into the woods to search for them. All night she traveled, and all day. When evening fell, she heard the rustle of wings, and seven swans settled down about her. They blew on to each other and resumed their human shape.
Silent for 7 years. Never speak a word, nor utter any sound, nor make any sign to say a thing. No matter what.
My brothers!
But that's not all.
You must knit us all 7 jackets of aster flowers, never breaking a single flower.
And once the 7 years have passed, if you have not said a thing, when we put on these garments, we'll return to our human form.
Hello, what is your name? Come be my bride. Come live with me and be my bride.
Who knows who she is? Who knows who she is?
There was like a wicked stepmother, a mother.
Spring turned to summer, turned to autumn, turned to winter. Spring turned to summer, turned to autumn, turned to winter.
Spring turned to summer, turned to autumn.
Spring turned to summer, turned to autumn, to
spring.
Why was Ralph's feet in the center? She gave birth. It was stolen by. It was stolen somehow. Spring turned to summer, turned to autumn.
She has eaten up your son. She must be a witch.
It is impossible.
Spring turned to summer, turned to autumn.
I want to tell you. I am innocent.
She has eaten up another son. She has eaten up your son. Why not destroy her?
She never said a word.
Why does she not speak? Tell it through to Finn. Tell it to Kusha.
I want to tell you. I am innocent.
Who knows who she is?
Vassar is framed. Vassar.
It is impossible.
Why did you not speak?
There was like a wicked step.
She has eaten up your son. She must be a witch. She has eaten up another son. She has eaten up your son. Why not destroy her?
She never said
it. It is impossible.
She gave birth. It was stolen.
It was stolen somehow. I want to tell you. I am innocent.
Senin çocuğu mu yedi? Neden onu öldürmeyesin ki?
Who knows who she is?
There was like a wicked stepmother. Mother.
She has eaten up another son. She has eaten up your son. Why not destroy her?
O başkasının çocuğu muydu? O senin çocuğun muydu? Neden onu öldürmeyesin ki?
I'm sorry.
Say the king. Sentence for the child of the man, for destruction for the children. She couldn't say order in the defense. Now it happened that day set for execution was the last day of the 7th year of asylum. How the jackets of the flowers were finished by one. It was lucky to sleep. The big mother-in-law come to drive her away and take her up half this California where she was to die. And while supporting the last yellow rays of setting sun, there was a great wealth of friends of her head. It was her brothers.
Thank you.
an hour, maybe the way.
The only way he saw her.
Yes.
Through the keyhole.
Yes.
And that made him fall in love.
That's what I'm telling you. So, she tries on a dress the next Sunday, and he sees her looking like the sun.
Let's dress up.
Let me finish. So he tells the cook to have the girl make him a bowl of soup, and when she does, a ring falls in. And he says he'll marry the girl whose finger fits the ring because he already knows.
Was it her mother's ring?
Come in.
I don't know.
Maybe that's why it was too big.
Come in.
It wasn't too big, it fit.
It fell off her hands into the soup.
I know you're there.
Maybe she put it there on purpose.
Why? Come in.
Maybe she saw he was spying.
Maybe it was too big at first, and then later on it fit.
Ew!
I don't know, so he tries the ring on all the others and it doesn't fit. And then he tries on her. And it fits. And he marries her. The end. I'm going home.
Me too, I'm going home.
Where are you going, my love, don't ever go there without.
having dinner when a stranger who was passing by stopped and asked if he might stay a while to break his journey. All was going well.
What then?
The clock began to strike 12.
Peter said nothing of what he had seen, for the family seemed to have noticed nothing at all.
What then?
The next day, when the clock once again began to strike 12,
that beautiful child belong? The one that comes and scratches at the floor in the corner of the room every day at the same hour.
But the father said that he had never seen a thing.
What a child! We have never seen her!
But surely she comes each day.
We've never seen a thing! Why would anyone ever want to marry you? was 17 years later. The young princes were no longer young and still at war. The surviving son of those three blind queens was all grown up.
Please give me something to eat. There are no more roots and herbs. The fish are gone from the stream. The hunger would drive us mad. We must leave the mountainside and bring us something to eat.
For the first time in his life, the boy went down to the mountainside. The path was rough, and he was not. He was one of the sweetest men, having been brought up among only the gentlest creatures on earth.
Please hurry. The hunger will drive us so mad.
Nothing of the world. He had lost his way. He wandered so far, he lost sight of the mountain. At last, he came to the edge of a great desert where he could see, shimmering on the horizon, a castle of black and white marble.
Please hurry. The hunger will drive us mad.
Now, this palace was built by the dread nursemaid. Once she had stolen the riches of the princess, everything there was under her curse. Fearful, lonely, and cursed. The young man didn't know this. So he crossed the desert and entered the palace. There was an ogre there, sitting on a chair.
Wounded.
All around him, strewn across the tiled floor, was the treasure of the world. That is apples and grapes and oranges and strawberries and such, but the ogre couldn't reach them. There was water and fountains and cups and urns, but the ogre couldn't reach them. In his simplicity, the young man thought,
perhaps his stomach is growling like mine when I'm hungry, as I am now, and my poor mother.
And without thinking at all,
he offered him an orange.
Transformed. Joao?
mother.
Troy, you've fallen asleep. Why are you wearing your father's old glasses, you silly boy?
I was reading his book.
Oh, sweetheart, you can't read.
I fell asleep.
I know.
I was dreaming. It wasn't an ogre.
An ogre?
The grandfather stole the rose from me and you were like a little girl.
What a funny dream.
And there, different ocean, kings, and birds.
Listen, let's go to bed. Once upon a time,
and they lived happily.
want you to do, especially for me.
Dedicated to the one I love.
This is dedicated to.